Good morning, students. In the previous class, we have introduced you Ohm's law and the concept of resistance. Basically, resistance, as we have obtained from the Ohm's law, that was a proportionality constant, and numerically it is taken as the ratio of potential difference to the current flow. Basically, what is the significance of resistance? This resistance, as resistance is a property by virtue of which it opposes the flow of charge through the conductor. Basically, as you can see in this figure, this is a conductor which is connected through a battery. Now, as current will start flowing from positive terminal to negative terminal, that will make electron to move in the opposite direction. So basically, resistance, it will oppose the flow of current in a circuit. Flow of current is obviously due to the movement of charges through the circuit. So resistance, it is the factor which opposes the flow of charges in the circuit. Now, as we know that for a given conductor, if the current is less current is flowing by, because it will have more resistance. As R is inversely proportional to I for a fixed or a constant potential difference. So, as you know, if the supply voltage at your home is 220 volt and different appliances, a bulb, a fan, a heater, everything is connected in different order, then resistance, depending upon the different resistance, current requirement of each of the appliance will be different. So, as for a fixed voltage, that is 220 volt, we can calculate current flowing through each of the appliance, maybe a small bulb, fan, refrigerator, heater, or any other electric gadgets. Now, as resistance, it is also defined as the ratio of potential difference across a conductor to the current flowing through it. Now, on the basis, we can define SI unit of resistance. SI unit of resistance is ohm. Symbolically, it is represented by this symbol. Now, so if you have to define 1 ohm, resistance is said to be 1 ohm if 1 ampere current flows through a conductor when the potential difference applied is 1 volt. So, 1 ohm will be equal to 1 volt per ampere. So, resistance of a conductor is said to be 1 ohm if 1 volt potential difference applied across the ends of a conductor produces current of 1 ampere. So, this 1 ohm can also be written as 1 ohm per ampere. Now, what is a basic cause of resistance? What is the basic concept from where we are saying that it is opposing the current? See here, in this figure, as electron is moving, so it consisting of large number of atoms, and having each atom may have some valence electron. So as I have taken earlier, that within the structure there will be 10 raised to the power 29 atoms or valence electrons per meter cube. So it means such a large number of valence electrons are present, and when these are getting energy from this external source, so they will start moving in random directions in order to move towards the positive terminal. But why the path will get changed? See, as the electron is moving, maybe some atom or ion is present in between. So this electron, while drifting towards the positive terminal, it will experience a collision with another atom or ion present in its path, due to which its path will be changed. Instead of going straight, it is suffering multiple collision with the atoms or ions present within the conductor. So that's why, due to this collision, there is opposition to the free flow of the electron. You can see, suppose here is a room, and you have to enter from this point and you have to go at this point. So if there is no hindrance in your path, it is clear path, you can go direct without any hindrance. But suppose one stool is placed here, one bench is placed here, another some object is placed here, then you cannot go straight. You will go here, then you will go from this path. Further, it may be possible at this point also some hidden, some point will be some obstruction can be there. You are moving from this point. Suppose you are going along this. Here you are finding obstruction. You go along this path. Further there is obstruction. You will go along this path. Further you are moving along this. Further obstruction. You can change your path. It means that electrons, these are not finding free path for flow. They are colliding with the atoms present in between their path, and hence the collision will be occurring. So basically, resistance arises due to frequent collision of free electrons with the atoms or ions of the conductor while drifting towards the positive end of the conductor. This is the basic cause. Sometimes this cause can be asked. So you must learn this point. Now, when we are taking resistance, this resistance obstruction to the flow of current or to the free flow of charges in a particular time. But this resistance which we are measuring, that is of the particular material, that is known as resistor. Resistor is a component and we are measuring its resistance. Suppose we are taking a fixed resistor, the symbolic representation which we will use in the circuit diagram. This is for fixed resistor, and whatever be its value, we will measure it, that will be resistance. If we are taking variable resistor, when you are just drawing this symbol, or sometimes this can be used, this is for rheostat also, or variable resistor. Rheostat itself is a variable resistor. This concept you have done in class 10th also. This is a resistor. One more point I will tell you about cell, because cell we are taking, this is a positive terminal, this is a negative terminal, and when you are making a battery, so what is a correct way to join three batteries, more batteries in the circuit? Is this way is correct or this way? Actually, you are taking here that one cell, two cell, three cell. For series combination of these, we are placing like this. But when symbolically we will not connect these two terminals as we have connected here, so continuity of current will not be maintained. So this is wrong symbolic representation of battery. For battery, you must connect this negative terminal with the positive terminal of the battery. And again, second cell. So here, for the second cell, negative terminal of the second cell should be connected to positive terminal of the third cell. So to maintain the continuity of the cell, to maintain the current to pass from one cell to another, these must be connected. If we will just draw the symbol and you will not join negative and positive, then it will be symbolically incorrect. So always join the terminals like this. Now, coming again to the resistance concept, we are taking again factors affecting resistance. Basically, we have taken that resistance equal to V upon R. But actually, this resistance is not depending upon potential difference and the current applied. See, resistance for a particular conductor, for a particular material is always fixed, depending upon some other parameters. Because suppose you are just purchasing any bulb, it is having fixed resistance. You have to apply voltage of 220 volt and certain amount of current will flow through it. So it doesn't mean that you are varying its resistance. It means resistance is not depending upon this voltage applied and the current flowing through it. So on what factor this resistance will depend? Now, this resistance, experiments have been conducted in order to find the factors on which it is depending, as different length wires have been taken, suppose 2L, 2L, and what was observed, the amount of current flowing through it. Then this all concept you have done in class 10, so I will take its conclusion only. I am just recalling the points. When you are taking small length and when you are taking bigger length, when you are taking bigger length, in that particular case resistance will increase and less current will flow. And your observation in the circuit arrangement can be that you are taking this particular wire having length 2L and connecting it to a battery, and a ammeter has been connected, maybe milliammeter or ammeter, whatever is required on the basis of its limits. Then if there is a deflection in the ammeter, certain amount of current will be flowing through it. And when you are taking another L length wire of same material connected to the same voltage, then the reading in both the cases it will vary. When here length is less, in that particular case current will be more. Why? Because resistance is less. Whereas in comparison to it, here length is more, so in that particular case amount of current flowing through it, that will be less. Why? Because here resistance is more. So on the basis of these kind of experiments, what we have concluded, that resistance is proportional to length of the wire. Similarly, another result was concluded by taking different area of cross section of same material wire, and we have found that resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section of the wire. Obviously, this was also performed by our scientists, and they have taken different area of cross sections of particular small components, small conductors, and they have got this particular result. Now, on combining these two, this resistance is proportional to L upon A. So this proportionality sign, when you will remove, you are getting a constant, that is rho. This rho, this is taken as specific resistance or resistivity. This is specific resistance or resistivity. So basically, this resistivity is fixed for a particular material. So it means this proportionality constant rho, it is depending upon, so you can say this resistance is depending upon nature of material. As you can see from here, that resistance was directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area of cross section, and when you are removing this proportionality sign, you are getting specific resistance. So this, it means that resistance is also depending upon rho, but rho, specific resistance, is fixed for a particular material. So hence it is also depending upon nature of material. So three factors: length, area, and nature of material. Now, so for nature of material, as we can take that nichrome wire, you will take the resistance of nichrome wire is 60 times the resistance of copper wire when you are taking the wire of same length and area of cross section. So now, from this relation, now this resistance, resistivity or specific resistance, so you can say if we have taken unit length and unit area of cross section, then from this we can say that the specific resistance is equal to resistance of conductor. So resistivity of a material is defined as the resistance of conductor of unit length and unit area of cross section. And in the another way, you can also define it as, it is the resistance offered by unit cube of material of a conductor. Resistance offered by unit cube of material of conductor. So by this way you can define resistivity or specific resistance. This is resistance, it should be resistance, not resistor. Now from this we can also define SI unit of resistivity. SI unit of resistivity, as R is equal to rho L upon A. From this, rho will be R A upon L. Now to get the unit, this resistance have unit ohm, area has unit meter square, and length has unit meter. So it will be ohm meter. That is ohm meter. So this is the SI unit of resistivity. Whereas ohm meter, this is an instrument for measuring resistance also. So here I have just introduced you the unit, and this is basically the instrument. Like if you want to measure voltage, what do you note? What do you, with the help of which instrument you will do it? Voltmeter. When you have to measure current, which instrument you will use? Ammeter or milliammeter or microammeter, depending upon its range. And similarly, if you have to measure resistance, then ohmmeter will be used. Now, next, deduction of Ohm's law. As we know, there is a relationship between current and drift velocity. Now, by using this relation, now we will obtain relationship between potential difference and current. As we know, drift velocity is given by E tau upon M, and E is equal to V upon L. One this result, another this result. We will use in this. So substitute, first of all, the value of drift velocity. And then you are getting A and E square E tau upon M. And E is equal to V upon L. So when you will substitute, then you will get an A and E square V tau upon M L, where A is area of cross section, N is number density of electron, E electronic charge, tau relaxation time, M mass of electron, V potential difference, and L is length. Now Ohm's law establish relationship between this current and this potential difference. So we have to take these two as variables. Now current will be taken as A N E square 2 upon M into V upon L. So now these parameters which you are taking, you have to take L along with. You have to take L here also, because we have to take relationship between voltage and current. So from this, this all is taken to be a constant. If the wire is of having fixed length, fixed area, and number of electrons per unit volume, electronic charge, and mass of electron, that all are fixed. So from this, V is equal to, this is M L upon N E square tau A into I. Just we have cross multiplied it, we have got this result. Now see, this particular result, you will treat this equal to R, as R is equal to M L upon N E square tau into A. Therefore, V is equal to R I. So this was a relation as per Ohm's law. So V is proportional to I. But what will be the value of resistance? This is the value of resistance. So if you have to deduce Ohm's law from the concept of drift velocity or from the concept of current flowing through a conductor, then start from these points. And finally, you are getting this particular point. Now, on this basis, let me discuss this result. Now see, in this result, as we have taken directly that R is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area. So if you compare that here, this M upon N E square tau, these all are fixed. And so you can take that R is proportional to L upon A. Or you can directly from here, you can take R equal to rho L upon A. After this, this should be the step, because now we are replacing this constant term by another factor, rho. And from here, rho comes out to be M upon N E square tau. So this is the formula for resistivity. So if you will take this as constant, now what we are concluding, that R is proportional to length upon area. So the same conclusion that we have just explained, that different experiments scientists have got the results, now mathematically also we have got this result. Now let me discuss this specific resistance. Basically, if we have taking a wire or a conductor having length L and area A, if the length of wire is doubled, area is halved, or if the length of wire is halved, area is tripled, then what will be the effect on resistivity, no change. This is important question. One mark question can be asked that if the dimensions of a wires are varied as per length, diameter, area of cross section, but this specific resistance is independent of dimensions of conductor. It is not depending upon this. You can compare it from here. See this rho, it is not proportional to length and area of cross section, but rather it is depending upon mass of electron that is fixed, n number density of electrons, E electronic charge to relaxation time. So it is independent of dimensions. Now, so on what factor? The factors on which resistivity depends. What are the factors? So first of all, it depend upon nature of material as well as temperature. These are two parameters on which conductivity, resistivity depends. Now let me discuss them one by one. As from the result, as from the expression rho equal to m and upon n e square tau, we get that rho is inversely proportional to number density of electrons. So it means number density of electrons that will depend upon the conductor, atom of a conductor. It means this n, how much number of electrons are present in a particular volume, that is depending only upon the nature of material. So by this way you can say specific resistance is fixed for a particular material. Second thing, temperature. Now in order to get the effect of temperature, we also know that this is also inversely proportional to relaxation time. So resistivity of a material of a conductor is inversely proportional to average relaxation time, which will also depend upon the temperature. Now we have to study the effect of temperature on relaxation time as well as on resistivity, that I will discuss here. So now we have to study the effect of temperature on resistivity and resistance. As well as the temperature increases, number density of electrons that is remain to be constant. It will not have any effect. So what happened? As the temperature increases, thermal speed of electron increases. So what happened due to it? Amplitude of vibration of metal ions increases. Amplitude of vibrations increases. Now, therefore, frequency of collision. As the ions will vibrate, so when the electrons are coming and they may collide, the frequency of collision will also increase. So when frequency of collision increases, then relaxation time decreases. And when this relaxation time decreases, so resistivity increases. I am repeating all this step, how this is, because this is a main concept. What is the effect of temperature on the resistivity and resistance? See, when the temperature increases, in simple terms you can say the ions which are present, that will start vibrating. So amplitude of vibration increases. So when amplitude of vibration increases, their frequency of collision of electron with the ion, they will go on increasing. Why? Because if the this your ion is not stable, this is vibrating continuously, so there will be more chances of collision of electron with those ions. So when those ions are colliding with these electrons, and hence in that particular case relaxation time will decrease. For what? Relaxation time of electron, because as the collision will be occurring, then it is vibrating about the position. Further, relaxation time, that is the time between the collision, that will go on decreasing. And when, as per this result, when this relaxation time decreases, then you can say specific resistance will increase. And then when you are saying the specific resistance is increasing, so it means resistance will also increase. So in simple terms you can say when the temperature increase, specific resistance and resistance, these both will also increase. This is a result which you have to learn, that with the rise of temperature, resistance or resistivity increases. It means specific resistance is proportional to temperature, or our resistance is also proportional to temperature. Now, graphical representation of specific resistance with temperature. So, when the temperature increases, the specific resistance will also increase, and the curve will follow this particular path, especially for the case of conductors. For conductors, specific resistance is quite low, whereas for insulators, specific resistance is high. Whereas semiconductors are the materials whose conductive property lie between conductors and insulator. So in that case, their resistivity also lie in between that of conductors and insulators. Now, conductivity, it is symbolically represented by symbol sigma, and it is taken as the reciprocal of resistivity. So sigma is equal to 1 by rho. Conductivity is reciprocal of resistivity. So SI unit of conductivity is ohm inverse meter inverse, or mho meter inverse you can take. Now this is the reciprocal of resistivity. Similarly, conductance is a term that is you are representing by G, as conductance of a conductor is the reciprocal of resistance. It is the reciprocal of resistance. Basically, what is the significance? That conductance of conductor is the ease with which electrons, free charges, can easily flow. Resistance is the obstruction to the flow of charges, whereas conductance is the easiness of electrons so that they can flow easily through a conductor. Now, SI unit of conductance is, that will be again as it is reciprocal of resistance, so it will be ohm inverse or mho or siemens, represented by capital S. So these are small terms that are conductivity, conductance, and as we have plotted graph between resistivity and temperature, likewise you can also plot graph between conductivity and temperature. We have plotted between resistivity and temperature, now we are plotting graph between conductivity and temperature. So, with the rise of temperature, resistivity increases, whereas with the rise of temperature, conductivity will decrease. So, the graph will follow like this. This will be just opposite to this. With the rise of temperature, this resistivity, or if you have been given resistance, for the resistance and temperature, or resistivity or temperature, you are following this curve. Similarly, if you have to plot the graph for conductivity with temperature, as conductivity is reciprocal of resistivity, so when the temperature increases, conductivity will decrease. This is especially for the case of conductors. For semiconductors, we will discuss later on. Now, one more term I am taking today, current density. Current density at a point inside the conductor, it is defined as the amount of charge flowing per second through a unit area. Through a unit area, specially held normal to direction of flow of charge. So it is defined as the amount of charge flowing per second through a unit area held normal to direction of flow of charge. Suppose this is an area, so whatever current is flowing normal through this area, so current density represented by symbol J, this is taken as current flowing per unit area. This is a case when this area is held perpendicular to direction of current. As you can see that the current is flowing here, and suppose you can imagine a ring is there. So current is passing like this. You can see this is a ring and the current lines, this is passing like a direction of current. This is all just a imagination point. We cannot see actually the concept of current in a direction. So now when this area is exactly normal, then you can take it as. But if area is not normal, this is not perpendicular to direction of current, so in that particular case, let me take this is the current and let this conductor is taken so that its area is represented along this direction. Now area vector is a vector perpendicular to the surface, so let the this area is making an angle theta with the direction of current. So now if you will resolve this area, the component of area along direction of current will be A cos theta. If the conductor is perpendicular, then directly we are taking as the area. But here if this area is not perpendicular, then the component of area along the direction of current you will take. So in that case, that component is this AX can be A cos theta. So current density will be current per unit that component. That means current upon A cos theta. So current in terms of current density can be JA cos theta, which is treated as the dot product of current density and area. So basically, this current is taken as the dot product of current density and area. This is also a result. You can use it in many numericals. Now, SI unit of current density. As current density is current per unit area. So, ampere per meter square. You can take it as ampere per meter square. Now, if you want to take current through the whole surface, current through a particular whole surface of a conductor, in that particular case, you will take this dot product and you will integrate it for the entire surface. As we have done this concept in electrostatic also, that you will find the current for a small element, small surface, then for the entire surface, you will obtain, you will integrate the current through a small surface of a conductor, and hence you will obtain current for the entire surface. So this is all for today. This current density is a new term for you today because this term you have never studied before. So current density is the current flowing per unit area, provided in that case that the conductor is perpendicular to direction of the current. But if the conductor is not perpendicular to direction of current, so we will take a component of area along the direction of current. So current density will be equal to current per unit that horizontal component of area. From this concept, we have taken this current in terms of current density. So current is also taken as dot product of current density and area, as it is a scalar quantity. So dot product of two vector quantities, that is a scalar that we are applying here. Now, apart from it, if we have to find current for the entire surface, then you have to find current for the small surface and integrate it for the complete surface. So you have to learn it as a result. This can be used in numericals. So this is a new concept of current density. Apart from it, we have discussed today resistance, factors on which resistance depend, as well as the origination of the concept of resistance in terms of mathematical factors. So this is all for today. This is quite easy concept, so give it a writing practice so that this concept is clear to you. So prepare it by writing and complete your notebook. So thank you. Have a nice day.